Should I buy a new smartphone? Or does banning plastic bags help the environment? Millions of arguments are shared on the web in discussion forums, question answering sites, news portals, and other places. We hypothesize that future information systems will use these arguments to assist us in answering our argumentative questions, and that this assistance will be both conversational and intuitive. As a step in this direction, we here present insights on the expectations for such assistance. We all face decisions daily. Some we take intuitively, but for others we have to pause and to ask ourselves, which path should I take? Where some decisions lead to actions, others we construct our view of ourselves or the world around us. You see here the result page of a current argument search engine for the question of whether banning plastic bags is good. You can see some pros and cons, and you might find something you have not thought about, but is this enough for you to really make meaning on the matter? As it turns out, one specific argument against banning plastic bags has been the focus of a post of the Search Research blog. Dan heard about a possible backfire of banning plastic bags in supermarkets and wondered how to make meaning of the situation with the search tools of today. To this end, he outlines a roadmap of questions to further his understanding. Notice how Dan's questions form one part of a conversation, where each question is based on answers of the imagined other conversant. This illustrates the role that argument search technology has to fulfill. We thus argue that argument search systems should be conversational, but also that these systems need an interface that allows to formulate questions, like the ones on the last slide, intuitively. Voice input seems to be especially suited, because, after all, we are using our voice to ask for reasons since early childhood. Moreover, the hands and gaze-free interaction makes the technology available in the many situations in our daily lives where we ponder which path to take. But it may still be a long road to this point, and to get there, we need to understand the expectations towards an argument search system. So we investigated these expectations in two ways: an online survey that I will detail now, and a user study with a simulated system that I will detail later in this talk. We hired a total of 500 people from 10 countries to participate in our survey. After a brief introduction to argument search, the survey collected expectations on when, why, and how the participants would likely use argument search. We here focus on the why, for which we selected 6 motivations that cover the categories of deciding on something and convincing somebody, based on a distinction from argumentation research, as well as entertainment. We added the last category, as fun is connected to both voice interfaces and argumentative discussions. We asked each participant the same question for each of the 6 motivations. If voice-based argument search were available today, how likely would you use it with this motivation? In addition to a 5-point rating, participants were able to provide comments for each motivation. We also clarified each motivation with an example scenario. As this graph shows, our selected motivations do cover a wide range in terms of popularity. Between as few as 25 and as many as 73% of the participants stated an extremely or very likely use of the different motivations. The entertainment motivations are deemed the most likely, and many participants stated that they would likely use an argument search system to have fun with a friend. Of course, system designers might choose to ignore the entertainment aspect for reasons of trustworthiness. However, this result also suggests that people may want to perform argument search together with others. The participants were less optimistic for the motivation of convincing others. However, some participants gave a comment on these motivations that they would fear to be embarrassed by the system providing silly arguments. We can thus expect that some people would rather use the argument search in preparation when the person to be convinced is not present. For the decision-making motivations, finally, we observe a large difference. If we again look at the comments, we see that many participants saw voting as too important and feared a manipulation of the system. To summarize, we found that the participants expected to use voice-based and conversational argument search especially for motivations of low risk, but can imagine a use both alone and together with others. Having collected the broad expectations, we additionally conducted a detailed user study with 18 participants. The participants performed 4 argument search tasks each, while being connected voice only to a human intermediary who simulated the argument search system. We then manually transcribed, segmented, and categorized each utterance. So when we analyzed the categories, we found that the participants used about an equal number of actions on inquiries, revealments, as well as generic and navigational actions. The inquiries are probably the most important for system design. Most were about getting arguments, but about a fifth were about getting context information for something from a previous argument, like word definitions or product features. In the online survey, about 2/3 of the participants stated they would need the possibility to ask the system for the source of an argument or for further evidence, but such inquiries occurred very rarely in our study. One reason could be that the participants questioned the arguments less than usual in our study, as, for one, they were talking to a human, and, second, they did not have to decide on something for real. However, this would imply that once an argument search system gained the trust of a user, it should also have the responsibility of indicating problematic sources or doubtful evidence. To conclude, I here presented some of our results on the question of why, when, and how people expect to perform voice-based argument search. We hope to have shown that argument search, by its nature, asks for a conversational form of interaction, and that, ultimately, the trust that users put in the system determines which questions they ask, but should also determine what the system provides without being asked.